that's called the shofar. That actually was initiated in the days of Abraham, when Abraham took Isaac up on top of Mount Moriah, and the whole concept there of him offering up his son, and then God withholding Abraham's hand, because obviously Isaac wasn't the son that would the father would ultimately give his life, and so to spare Isaac's life, what the Lord did was he provided a ram that was caught in the thicket, and it was caught by the horn. And so the Jews, ever since that day, have celebrated with the shofar, remembering that day that God would ultimately end up providing his son, who would redeem mankind from sin. And it's always symbolized by the shofar. Throughout its history, it has been come to be used for all sorts of different things. It was used to call the armies of Israel together to defend the nation. It was used on many of the holy days, which we, of course, call holidays, to bring what's called in the scripture a holy convocation, which means an assembly set apart for the purposes of God. And so we thought it would be kind of cool to blow it here this evening, to call the meeting together, or our holy convocation, as we celebrate this incredible time of year, and look to the entrance of our Redeemer, ultimately the one pictured there way back on Moriah, the entrance of our Redeemer to redeem us. And one day, the scripture tells us, Paul tells us, that we're going to hear a horn like that again, and the church is going to be called out of here to meet the Lord by a call that's going to sound something very similar to that, obviously much louder. There won't be anybody that will miss it, in other words. So we just thought that was a really cool way to begin the evening. So let me pray.